The Constitution of India is the supreme law. It provides a comprehensive framework to guide and govern the country, keeping in view her social, cultural, and religious diversity. Constitution of India came into force on 26 January 1950. At the time of its adoption, the Constitution contained 395 articles, 8 schedules, and had about 1,45,000 words, making it the longest national constitution to ever be adopted. Every article in the Constitution was debated by the members of Constituent Assembly, who sat for 11 sessions and 167 days to form the Constitution over a period of 2 years and 11 months.
We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. And our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
We the people of India, it indicates the ultimate sovereignty of the people of India. Sovereignty means the independent authority of the state not being subject to the control of any other state or external power. Sovereign. This term means that India has its own independent authority and it is not a dominant of any other external power. In the country, the legislator has the power to make laws which are subject to certain limitations. Socialist. The term means that the achievement of socialist ends through the democratic means. It holds faith in a mixed economy where both private and public sectors coexist side by side. It was added in the preamble by 42nd Amendment 1976. Secular. The term means that all religions in India get equal respect, protection and support from the state. It was incorporated in the preamble by 42nd Constitutional Amendment 1976. Democratic. The term implies that the Constitution of India has an established form of constitution which gets its authority from the will of the people expressed in an election. Republic. The term indicates that the head of the state is elected by the people. In India, the president is elected as the head of the state.
The constitution helps to maintain integrity in the society and to promote unity among the citizens to build a great nation. The main objective of the Indian constitution is to promote harmony throughout the nation. The factors which help in achieving this objective are justice, equality, liberty, fraternity.
It is necessary to maintain the order in society that is promised through various provisions of fundamental rights and directive principles of state policy provided by the Constitution of India. It comprises of three elements, which is social, political and economic.
Equality. The term equality means no section of society has any special privilege and all the people have given equal opportunities for everything without any discrimination. Everyone is equal before the law.
Liberty. The term liberty means freedom for the people to choose their way of life, have political views and behavior in the society. Liberty does not mean freedom to do anything. A person can do anything but in the limit set by the law.
Fraternity. The term fraternity means a feeling of brotherhood and an emotional attachment with the country and all the people. Fraternity helps to promote dignity and unity in the nation.